today I'll be fixing this truck, doing the oil change, and also got the wiper blade and arm to install. So that's gonna be fun. Anyways, I'm approaching the truck and we start working on it, so it should be fun. Okay, here it is. It's a truck. So it's probably close still. I'm gonna be replacing this wiper arm here because the hoses on this thing are, I don't know, someone cut them off, so we got the new wiper arm and also wiper blades. Also, I will do the oil change on this thing. Okay, so we just we're probably gonna pull it closer here to the garage. Like that. The garage. We have to get a creeper and then some tools, and we're gonna start working. Okay, so I'm gonna grab some tools like this. I need a 15. It's 15. And then ratchet and the socket to remove the wiper arm. Okay. So let me try something. This is 15 mil. So. Okay, it's fell on the ground. So, taking off this nut. Right here. I'm gonna wiggle this and remove it. It's the old wiper arm assembly. I'm gonna install this new one. When I lift this up, then there's this T-pin connector that's also damaged right here, so I'll have to change this. What I did is basically cut off that old T from here because it was like molded together or something, and right now I'm just doing my own T-pin. So, and hopefully it's gonna work, and then I'm gonna connect these. And yeah, and I'll be ready to install my wiper arm and then change the wiper blades too. This is how it looks now. Okay, and now I just gotta feed it through that hole right there. The last oil change was done 5,000 miles ago. It was like a year ago. And it consumed a little bit of oil. Maybe it's just I think one of the lines are leaking. I don't know if those are engine oil lines, the cooling, or that's for the trans, but anyways, I'm gonna do the oil change now. I'm gonna put everything here, open this up. Yeah, this thing, like, this cap got like really stuck. It's pretty dry here. Nobody has opened anything here. Okay, let me grab this wrench. Crawl here. Okay, I got some leaks here. Anyways, loosen this up. Let's go.
train now. Filter.
Oh, I put the drain plug back in. I'm just draining the filter. I remove the filter. And basically, I'm just gonna wait a little bit and then, you know, clean everything up, put a new filter in. Put the oil in. Everything's tightened up. Good to go. Look at this nice car right there. It's from Wisconsin. Yay. This one is not diesel though, but it looks nice.
Maybe no more diesel.
It's true?
What day?
So I'm sitting in the Honda Accord 97. You guys probably know from previous videos and stuff. It's got 160,000 miles right now. So I did the oil change like 1,000 miles ago or so. So anyways, what I'm gonna do today is I have these glasses and the ultraviolet light. I'm gonna try to check for EC leaks because it's somewhere here. And they did refill the AC, but it was like 2 years ago, and right now it's pretty much empty. So I already popped the hood, but just make sure. And then I'm gonna go and open it up and see. Here's our gaskets that I did. So they're looking pretty good, no leaks, pretty dry. So anyways, I just wanna check really quick. This side looks really good too. They did the valve cover gaskets, so. Anyways, just trying to see, check the AC leaks. Probably this compressor is gonna be no good. Okay, let me put my glasses on. Here's the car right here. So it's a pretty good car. I mean, for the age and stuff, you know, not too bad, not too rusty. This one particularly. And then I was restoring these wheels. As you can see, and they don't look so bad. So if you're interested, you know, there's gonna be a link in the description how I fixed these wheels. They were really rusty. Okay, anyways, now I'm gonna go ahead and start checking for AC leaks. This pretty much sucks because it's too bright outside now, so I'm gonna have to come back when it's dark, and then I'll try to check for AC leaks, because right now it's like I can't see anything at all, and I don't know if I'll be able to see. Hopefully when they refilled the AC last time and they put the UV dye in it. But anyways, that's it for now. I'm just gonna come back later. That's what you basically see. We have the amber glasses on. oil level in this thing. Let's see how it's doing. Oh yeah, it did drop. It's almost no oil. Low in oil. So within 1,000 miles, it some of it got burned, some of it leaked out. Pretty crusty, needs a wash too. Okay, anyways, now what I want to do is I'm gonna actually start it up. I'm gonna turn on the AC. Let's see if the compressor kicks in. No, it did not. It was hard for you to see, but I hope you can trust me. And then there's nothing in there at all, like the compressor doesn't kick on, so it's probably not enough freon or whatever. So then let's see, there's, yeah, it's warm air, nothing in there pretty much. SRS light on. Well, anyways guys, so the AC blows hot air and compressor doesn't kick on, so I'm gonna double check this thing, and you know, I'm gonna come back when it gets dark, and I'm gonna try to check for AC leaks. Like I said, I don't know if they put the UV dye the last time they you know, refilled the system, so hopefully they did and I'll be able to see at least something, you know. If not, then, you know, I'll most likely have to, you know, refill the system and then, you know, try to, you know, find the leak that way, you know, give it some time. Gotta top this thing off. Still at the minimum, needs a lot. Yeah, so it took the whole quart. That's how low this thing was. It's most likely not burning it, just leaks. So we'll wipe this off. Back.